In this video, I'll show you how to scale the floor plan and the elevations of the cabin project in Paperspace. So after you've finished drawing your floor plan and your elevations, what you'll want to do is get out of model space, and so come over here and pick on the first tab that says floor plan. And when that opens, you may see that your floor plan is not at the scale we want it to be. In other words, it'll look too small or may look too large like this, either way. So here's how to remedy that. You'll want to get into Paperspace. So you can click down here on that word that says model, or you can double click out here into this area. And we have a viewport, and the viewport scale is what determines the scale of what we see in here. The viewport is this orange rectangle. So I'm going to select that. I'm going to pick on the orange rectangle. Now, you'll look right down here on your status bar in the lower right corner. And if there's a lock here, if the lock is dark, like it's locked, then you'll have to click on that and unlock it. But what you want to do is pick on this down arrow next to this string of numbers right here. And we want to find the scale that we want to use, which is actually 3/16 of an inch equals 1 foot. So we click on that, and you're going to see your view zoom in or out. Now, it may not be centered where you want it to be, so in which case you could double click inside your window there, and you could pan. But if you scroll, you could change the scale again. So we want to pan it, get it centered. Then we can double click out here, pick on the viewport again, come back over here and set it again to 3/16 equals 1 foot. And then what I would do is lock this viewport by clicking on that lock right there. What that does is if you double click inside here, you can't do anything to change the scale or anything like that. So model space, you're locked out of model space essentially. All right, so let's look at that for the elevations. I'm going to pick on the elevations tab. And these views are going to almost completely fill up our sheet. So again, I want to double click out here. Actually, I'm in paper space. I can see paper right here. I'm going to pick on the viewport, pick on this down arrow, go to 3/16 equals 1 foot. Now you can see that I'm a little bit close to my border here. So what I need is to move this over just a little bit. So I'm going to double click inside. Hold down with the wheel of my mouse and just move this over, maybe bring it down just a little bit, get it where it's situated there. Then I'm going to double click outside here, which put me back into paper, or I could have clicked on the word model down here. I'm going to select that viewport again. I want to just make sure it still says 3/16 inches equals 1 foot, and if it does, I'm going to pick on the lock, and I'm going to lock this. That locks it into place. So now I'm ready to print, and I can be sure that those views are going to be at the right scale, which is 3/16 equals 1 foot. And that's, you'll notice we even say that in our note, 3/16 inch equals 1 foot. We'll also write that into our title block over here. All right, so I hope that helps you print this project.